Core Terminology Communist Party of China Constitution Chapter 3 Central Party Organizations
Hexing Shu Yu Chongguo Gong Chan Dang Xian Fa Di San Zhang Dang de Zhongyang Zu Zhi
Article 19. The National Congress of the Party shall be held once every 5 years and convened by the Central Committee, in the event that the Central Committee deems it necessary or more than one-third of provincial-level party organizations put forward a request. A National Congress may be convened early, except in unusual circumstances, it may not be postponed. The number of delegates to the National Congress and the procedures governing their election shall be determined by the Central Committee.
第19条，党的全国代表大会每5年举行一次，由中央委员会召集。中央委员会认为有必要，或者有1/3以上的省一级组织提出要求，全国代表大会可以提前举行。如无非常情况，不得延期举行。全国代表大会代表的名额和选举办法，由中央委员会决定。
Article 20. The functions and powers of the National Congress of the Party are as follows. 1. To hear and examine the reports of the Central Committee. 2. To examine the reports of the Central Commission for Discipline Inspection. 3. To discuss and make decisions on major issues concerning the party. 4. To revise the constitution of the party. 5. To elect the Central Committee. And 6. To elect the Central Commission for Discipline Inspection.
第20条，党的全国代表大会的职权是：一、听取和审查中央委员会的报告；二、审查中央纪律检查委员会的报告；三、讨论并决定党的重大问题；四、修改党的章程；五、选举中央委员会；六、选举中央纪律检查委员会。
Central Commission for Discipline Inspection.
Central Commission for Discipline Inspection.
Article 21. The functions and powers of the National Conference of the Party are to discuss and make decisions on major issues and to replace members and elect additional members of the Central Committee and the Central Commission for Discipline Inspection. The number of Central Committee members and alternate members to be replaced or newly elected shall not exceed 1/5 of the respective totals of full and alternate members elected to the Central Committee by the National Congress of the Party.
第21条，党的全国代表会议的职权是讨论和决定重大问题，调整和增选中央委员会、中央纪律检查委员会的部分成员，调整和增选中央委员及候补中央委员的数额，不得超过党的全国代表大会选出的中央委员及候补中央委员各自总数的1/5。
Article 22. The Central Committee of the Party is elected for a term of 5 years. In the event that a National Congress is convened early or postponed, the term shall be shortened or extended accordingly. The length of party membership of Central Committee members or alternate members must be a minimum of 5 years. The number of members and alternate members of a Central Committee shall be determined by the National Congress.
第22条，党的中央委员会每届任期5年，全国代表大会如提前或延期举行，它的任期相应的改变。中央委员会委员和候补委员必须有5年以上的党龄。中央委员会委员和候补委员的名额由全国代表大会决定。
Empty seats on the Central Committee shall be filled by alternate members in order of the number of votes they were elected by. Plenary sessions of the Central Committee are convened by the Political Bureau of the Central Committee, and are to be convened at least once annually. The Political Bureau shall report on its work at the plenary sessions and accept their oversight. When the National Congress is not in session, the Central Committee shall carry out its resolutions, direct all party work, and represent the Communist Party of China in external relations.
中央委员会委员出缺，由中央委员会候补委员按照得票多少依次递补。中央委员会全体会议由中央政治局召集，每年至少举行一次。中央政治局向中央委员会全体会议报告工作，接受监督。在全国代表大会闭会期间，中央委员会执行全国代表大会的决议，领导党的全部工作，对外代表中国共产党。
Central Committee of the Party is elected for a term of 5 years. Article 23, the Political Bureau.The Standing Committee of the Political Bureau, and the General Secretary of the Central Committee of the Party are elected at the plenary session of the Central Committee. The General Secretary of the Central Committee must be generated from among the members of the Political Bureau's Standing Committee. Between plenary sessions of the Central Committee, the Political Bureau and its Standing Committee shall exercise the functions and powers of the Central Committee.The Secretariat of the Central Committee is the working body of the Political Bureau of the Central Committee and its Standing Committee. Members of the Secretariat are nominated by the Political Bureau's Standing Committee and must be approved at a plenary session of the Central Committee.
第二十三条，党的中央政治局。中央政治局常务委员会和中央委员会总书记由中央委员会全体会议选举。中央委员会总书记必须从中央政治局常务委员会委员中产生。中央政治局和他的常务委员会在中央委员会全体会议闭会期间行使中央委员会的职权。中央书记处是中央政治局和他的常务委员会的办事机构，成员由中央政治局常务委员会提名。中央委员会全体会议通过。
The General Secretary of the Central Committee is responsible for convening meetings of the Political Bureau and its Standing Committee and shall preside over the work of the Secretariat. Members of the Central Military Commission of the Party are decided on by the Central Committee. Chairperson of the Central Military Commission.Assumes overall responsibility over the work of the commission. Central leading bodies and leaders elected by a central committee shall, when the next National Congress is in session, continue to preside over the day-to-day work of the party until new central leading bodies and leaders have been elected by its successive central committee.
中央委员会总书记负责召集中央政治局会议和中央政治局常务委员会会议，并主持中央书记处的工作。党的中央军事委员会组成人员由中央委员会决定。中央军事委员会实行主席负责制，每届中央委员会产生的中央领导机构和中央领导人，在下届全国代表大会开会期间，继续主持党的经常工作。直到下届中央委员会产生新的中央领导机构和中央领导人为止。
Article 24. Party organizations in the Chinese People's Liberation Army shall carry out their work in accordance with the instructions of the Central Committee. The Central Military Commission is responsible for party work and political work in the armed forces.And shall prescribe the organizational system and organs of the party in the armed forces.
Article 24, 中国人民解放军的党组织根据中央委员会的指示进行工作。中央军事委员会负责军队中党的工作和政治工作，对军队中党的组织体制和机构作出规定。
Chinese People's Liberation Army，
中国人民解放军。
Next is Chapter 4, Local Party Organizations, Chinese Communist Party Constitution.
Next is Chapter 4, Local Party Organizations, Chinese Communist Party Constitution.